When you need to find that obscure record or group of records in NetSuite, how do you do that? Let's take a look at finding records in NetSuite. Did you know there are two basic ways to find records? The first way is by simply navigating to lists of records from your navigation center. The second way is by using the global search bar. First, let's look at navigating to lists of records. You would start either on the Transactions tab or the Lists tab, depending on the type of record you are looking for. From there, choose the specific type of record, like employees, that you want to see, and NetSuite will take you to a page listing every record in that type. From that list, you can search for the exact record you need. You can streamline the search process by using the filter options at the top. For example, in the list of employees, you could change the view, set specific filters, and apply a quick sort. The filter options available to you will differ based on the view that you have set. Quick sort allows you to sort by records that were recently created, recently modified, recently viewed, etc. The options in quick sort remain the same no matter which view you are using. Searching for records from a list is especially helpful if you're looking for a group of records that meet a certain criteria rather than one specific record. If you're looking for that one very specific record, though, then using the global search bar might be your best bet. The global search bar, located top and center in NetSuite, allows you to search for anything in NetSuite. Your search can be as broad or as specific as you need it to be. For example, suppose you searched for employee in the global search bar. NetSuite would bring up everything it can find that has employee in the name. Once you find the exact record you need, you could select either edit or view next to the record to open it. NetSuite will bring up many different types of records when you use a broad search like this. If you know the exact type of record you are looking for, then you can use some global search tools to narrow down your search. Two of those tools are the search prefix and the keyword. A search prefix is just an abbreviation of the type of record you need. If you're looking for a specific record within a record type, then you would use a colon after the search prefix and include a keyword from the record you are searching for. For example, if you were searching for an employee named Joe, your search prefix would be something like EM or EMP, followed by a colon, and the keyword would be Joe. The abbreviations you use as search prefixes are entirely up to you. You just want to make sure that the abbreviation can apply only to one type of record. So you might want to avoid ambiguous abbreviations like INV, since INV could mean either inventory or invoice, and your search might pull up some irrelevant records. Another tool is OR. Inserting OR into your search allows you to search for multiple keywords at once. For example, suppose you want to pull up employee records for all the employees named either Joe or Bob. Your search would be something like emp colon Joe or Bob. The percent wildcard is another search tool, and it tells NetSuite how to search for the information in your keyword. Placing percent directly after your keyword will instruct NetSuite to return only results that begin with your keyword. Placing percent directly before your keyword, on the other hand, will instruct NetSuite to return any results that contain your keyword. Another final common search tool is using the plus sign after your keyword. The plus sign tells NetSuite to include inactive records in the search along with the active records. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.